And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Robert Kelly.
Today,
so much to talk about.
There's so much to talk about, and it's—I mean—the energy in the room is—it's
good.
It's electric.
Boogie woogie woogie.
Boogie woogie woogie. We have the
guest of guests on the bonfire.
I mean, he's not even a guest. He's the bonfire.
In the bonfire verse.
Nah, me.
Here he is.
He was the bon of bonfire.
He's the bon. You are the fire. And I'm the one that's going to put
it
out.
And that's why now it's coming.
I got my...
Bobby's here to step all over. Fire's dangerous, guys.
You're going to burn down a forest.
I'm going to change it to the Bon Bon.
You got a Not Dan shirt?
Yeah, you got a Not Dan shirt on,
so
dude.
So great.
I have my Not Dan shirt on.
I walked up and that was the first thing you showed me.
That's great. Not Dan.
Yeah. Dude, this is... What's up?
What's up,
dude? You,
what's
up, guys?
In the motherfucking house. We had so much to talk about. Me and Bobby really shared.
Dude, this was...
We trauma bonded last night, but we were in the trauma.
We were in the trauma, and you changed the course of my kid's life, I think, last night.
I love it.
I don't love it.
Where'd you guys go?
We went to go see The Cure at Madison Square Garden.
Christine's smiling, everyone.
Christine barely enjoyed it. I didn't make Christine miserable during
it,
though.
The band barely enjoyed it.
No. I'm saying she was... You looked miserable.
No, I was a great, great sport through it all. I sat there. I tried to have a good time. I stood up for the songs that a bunch of songs until I couldn't anymore.
Did you pop on any of them?
Sure. Burn, the song from The Crow.
Yeah.
Good tune. Lullaby. It's just funny. I just kept going. The Spider-Man.
you were doing that all. Were there any that got you?
Yeah. Yeah, the last one when I got to leave. I hated it.
Dude, that is the
Bobby,
worst.
Bobby, the best face I saw on Bobby when I would look back four rows to him was him just going like, it was a real like the, okay, how many more? And when me and Bobby's face and text to each other at one point, he did.
So you guys weren't sitting next to each other.
He did 15 songs and then he came out and he goes, it was an encore, by the way. When he came out for his first encore, he goes, oh, we're about halfway through the show now. We're like,
no.
Come on, dude.
Were you, and you guys weren't... Bobby's face is so sad. You weren't sitting next to each other.
No.
And Bobby lapped the arena at one point to go get earplugs for Max. It was just to do something.
So you guys are having a miserable time.
Dude,
we were laughing through the thing.
We were laughing, but it was sad. I mean, it went from... It opened up just sad...
What's The Cure? What do you think you were going to get?
Well, dude, you need a cure for The Cure.
The opening band, by the way, was a Scottish Cure, and they were called the Twilight Sad.
No, they weren't.
Dude. And they just performed for a packed house of sitting people getting through them to go hear the same exact songs again.
It was the Cure. They were in the dark.
Was it just sad Scottish rock before the Cure?
Yeah.
That's exactly what it was.
It was Scottish Cure. They're the same exact
and
music.
And because of his accent and the lead singer of the Cure, he's from Manchester, you can't understand a word they fucking say to you.
It's just this. It's like, oh,
No. He's talking about when he taught his in-between songs.
Oh, really?
The in-between
once in a while when he'd go,
I want to kill myself. Every day is hard for me to pick myself up out of bed.
Well, this is what the show's missing.
I want to end it all right
Bobby,
now.
Do that Scottish guy.
It can only be one.
Okay.
I want to get name in a golden pages. Hey, I went to the Cure concert last night.
Every day you re-earn that chair again.
Guys, and that's why I'm coming by today. I'm coming by today to let you know about a little thing that I've been working on called Dan's Voice Academy. We're launching this bad boy July 1st.
Sign me up!
I got guest speakers, Frank Caliendo. Michael Winslow, there is a contract out. We have not heard back.
I'm in. Jim McClure is going to pay for it.
Well, funny you bring up Jim McClure. He was an early investor. We signed this thing on the ground level, and we've been building up.
Get your family discount on that.
I will teach you how to do a Rodney Dangerfield.
Buddy,
dude,
first of all, he looks like if Ron Jeremy was the Joker.
He's bad.
I'm sorry, but it's the thought of him going, do you want to know how I got this boner? Do you want to know why your pussy makes me so hard?
He's bad, dude. He has...
People think my penis is big, but it's only really 2 inches. 2 inches from the floor.
He looks like security.
He knows he's a fat, ugly clown, mm-hmm. So he stays off camera until he's right on top of it. But there's no stage show.
There's no production whatsoever. They have 2 90-inch plasmas hanging from the ceiling.
He's not wrong. They're so small.
And then they have stock fucking like iPhone footage behind them, like just raindrops, and then just a pretty black girl at the beach.
He's sad, dude. Yeah. He doesn't have enough time to think about a stage show. Him popping up on that, though, I'm not gonna lie, the quality is SD on the screen. If I'm looking at you, Jay, mm-hmm. and you were to tell me what's on the screen, I would honestly say Leatherface.
It's crazy.
Yeah, I would honestly say Texas.
Yeah, it's right before he closes the basement door.
Yeah, or when they get away and he's just holding a chainsaw on stage. Just angrily. How long was the show? Front to back, 17 hours.
I believe it was 17 hours.
We were in the room. Mm-hmm. 3 hours and 45 minutes.
I actually went in and got french fries and a hamburger, and I left. They had breakfast, serving breakfast.
That is so fucking long.
Danny, you don't even understand. I don't want to go to this. I don't want to go.
He didn't want to go.
Lou, turn my mic up. I need some more heat.
I don't want to go to
this. Listen to my voice.
Well, you said.
I didn't want to be there. I begged Jay, please. And he said, we're going to have fun. Ari's coming. Sal's going. Josh, Christine, bring Matt. We're gonna have fun. First of all, I got a phone call this morning from Joe DeRosa, and he called me early, which is usually a bad thing with Joe.
Yeah, that means he's stewing on.
No, he was calling to say how much that sucked.
Well, he called me up, and I go, hey Joe, what's up? Because I know it's coming. And he goes, hey buddy, how are you? I'm just calling to say hi. And I went, really? Oh, cool. Hi. And then I heard, hey, 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 hey. And it was stupid Keith Robinson. On the phone with me. And they were in a skybox with tater tots and all kinds of snacky poos.
Why were they up there?
Because they were with Sal.
Oh,
yeah. I was next to two lesbians, a middle-aged lesbian.
Keith went to the Cure?
Not Keith. Keith can't go anywhere.
Who?
It was him trashing me for going to the Cure.
Oh.
Him and DeRosa.
Oh, gotcha.
Because we were sitting in the...
Joe was in the box.
He was in the box with Ari and Aziz and... Yep. And they had tater tots and snacks and drinks, and it was a wonderful time.
Sitting next to a weeping lesbian.
I was next to a weeping lesbian, and I'm pretty sure it was two aliens.
Me and Christine are
two bald guys with hats that they stole off the human.
The thing that powers our spaceship is sadness.
Damn, they were there. They didn't stand up the whole show. They would look at each other and then look back at the show, and then they were gone.
Now it makes sense that. The lead singer of The Cure looks like "You got any sugar?"
He really tried the bug.
Yeah,
he goes, bug.
"You got any sadness?"
"I had a cat. Means the world to me.
I had a girlfriend. She becoming me. I'm pretty bummed about it."
It is what the show's missing. Can you just lay some shit down once a week,
dude? This. It was mind-numbingly bad.
3 hours and 45 minutes
of sadness. Of fucking pure fucking sadness.
The Twilight sad first.
I mean, dude.
Six different ways up in my heart.
Every
hey,
song.
Everyone. I guess, you know, we shut down selling sodas.
Every
They're
song.
Bad for you.
We just ran out of extra large t-shirts. Can tell you what you like.
Let me tell you how boring their show is and how shitty their music is. He sounded perfect.
Great.
Really?
Fantastic.
He sounded
really
perfect.
He sounded
like the album.
Just like the album.
Let's maybe phrase that. He sounded like the creep that he is on the album. Yeah. Okay?
Damn, dude. I like Bobby Left an Enemy.
He hit all the notes.
Bobby Left an Enemy of, what's his name? Robert
Smith.
Robert
dude,
Smith.
He hit all the notes.
Mm-hmm.
He hit the highs high. Mm-hmm. Everything he was supposed to do. He didn't bullshit any song.
Yeah.
And it's still.
Dude, it sounded like you guys sat through.
Here's what they did.
Like a presentation.
Also about an additional, with no exaggeration, 3 to 4 minute intro on every song of just instrumental.
That you can't understand a word. His Manchester accent, his Guy Ritchie shitty accent.
Mate.
Here's the thing, too. They held us hostage. Hostage.
How?
They did a fucking double encore.
Two encores.
Until they got to the last...
7 songs and 9 songs are the encores.
Dude, they did
Wait,
the...
Wait, excuse me?
7-song encore, encore 1.
That's
9 songs.
No, dude, that's a troll. That's not...
But they
you don't do a 9-song double fucking encore.
The second half of the show is encores.
Dude, that's crazy.
This is how I know this guy's a dickhead. He's an asshole and he knows that we were fucking... He was just punishing us. On the last one, he said...
Bobby's saying that you guys are just getting punished.
Because he made a joke.
He's just fucking punishing you.
He made a joke and it was funny, but I know he knows what he was doing to all of us.
Yeah.
Because he went, okay, this is a new song. He's playing a new song.
On the second,
and then he goes like this. It's called Blood Red Sadness of Death or something like that. And we all went, what the fuck? And he went, I'm just joking. And he went into the song, but like,
it can't all be sad.
Then he was kidding. And then he went into his hit song. What song was it?
Oh no.
Friday.
He started doing, he goes, the new song called Tuesday's Gray.
Who knows? Yeah,
and he kept going. It gets the line from the song. He goes, Tuesday. He was just giving a little quirky setup for it. Here's the problem I had.
So do you have any sugar?
In the first encore, the second or first song he did in the encore. No, it is. It was the first song in the encore. Do you remember? So, Bobby, we have to go through a lot of these musicians with you on the show, but Lisa Gale.
God damn, dude.
Is a crazy... She was a crazy housewife whose husband at one point.
Dude, bring up oh my god, Bobby, the hits that you get to learn, I get to watch them through your eyes.
Dude, if I have to go to another one of these
I'll quit.
You'll see the point I'm making in a moment.
This is a rich lady whose husband pays for her music videos. This song rules.
I'd rather went to this last night.
Yeah, honestly, I would have gone with you. I would have gone to see Lisa Gale. I don't know about Kira.
I'd learn line dancing for this show.
That's when my 3 second rule comes into play.
What is it, you old hot?
You can only look for 3 seconds, then look away.
I'm into this.
The kind of rules you had in school. It's just a 3 second rule. It's my 3 second rule.
Everybody's smiling in the room right now.
Yeah.
Everybody's smiling.
They are.
Opposite
and also,
of Robert
Christine,
Smith. Robert Smith, get your shit together. Call up Lisa Gale, find out what the secret sauce is, and put it in.
Pop on coffee and tea so we get to taste it. And then I'm going to play the Cure. Connection I have here.
Okay.
I'm gonna get a taste of Lisa Gale. She's batshit crazy.
Everybody should go see The Cure and then go see her, and that will make you like this person.
Yeah, for sure. I'm
in love with her.
She cleansed the palate.
And I love her fucking necklace too from Arizona.
All of it, dude. It's such mom jewelry.
To me, this is the hit.
Is this Coffee and Tea or Be With Me? It's fucking jam, dude.
I like both of those.
Yeah, do well. Coffee, tea, or you get this piece of ace. Look at all the fucking... Turquoise, dude. The turquoise warrior.
I like the turquoise.
Lisa Ale, the turquoise minx.
Luke, can you please give her a respectful volume, please?
Drink it in, Bobby.
It doesn't matter what you use. So you got my heart pounding.
Well, you gotta watch, Bobby, also.
Her Macho Man glasses.
She is crazy. She's wearing Macho Man glasses. All her mom clothes.
I'm nothing wrong with any of this so far.
Is right here. Look at this hold. That's one of the best things ever. She holds his face. Got me going.
Coffee or tea or be with me.
Oh, yeah.
No matter what you choose. It's just the first time being with you. You're the one that makes me.
I love this.
They just hold these pictures.
Do that right there.
The hand on the thighs is her move.
She doesn't know what to do with her mouth after she's done singing in between.
She says it.
She looks like the... Do you remember in Insidious Part 3 when they found that it was a guy dressed like a woman?
No.
That's what she looks like.
Dawn has that outfit. I mean, just FYI.
She got a Lisa Gale?
She's got a Lisa Gale.
So, now, Bobby, to fill you in now. So, Lisa Gale has a song... I guess when she was younger, she had a child pass away. Now, that's not funny. Unfortunately, the song she wrote about it is, because she's not a good musician, and they really go on the nose with it. And one of the lines is, she goes, "Why did my child have to die?" It's crazy. Christine, please.
How'd the child die? This is sad.
I don't,
Iraq War.
But I mean, the song is written, it's like it was written by AI, because she's like, remember right in the beginning, she's like, "I brought you home from the hospital, and then a tragedy happened."
I want her to write a song for Max that I lost Max to a Cure concert.
Oh, yeah. Now my son's all sad.
If you recall, they also do in this video, they do the little boy on a swing, and then
he's gone.
Disappears while he's swinging.
Really makes you think.
She throws it all out there. The point I will make about this...
She looks like she's in the Fabulous Freebirds. That bombed.
Can you put
it? No, it didn't. I liked it.
But it does. She
I had one.
Is it because
I had
you saw Zach's post today? I saw Zach Amigo posted for Father's Day.
Oh, about Michael PSA. Yeah, I was just saying because of her. Yeah, that was.
She does have Michael PSA.
I told you, the older women get, they start to dress like Starship Commanders. I said this before on the show, and it's a fucking fact. Look at women in their 50s, 60s.
Starship Commanders?
They become generals. They get shoulder pads, and they start wearing fucked up hats. They look like Star Trek.
Dude, they're like when a country gets taken over by a military leader.
Yeah, 100%. Look.
They dress like warlords?
Yeah, they do.
They dress like third world warlords.
Like, do you remember when we met each other in college? I was a woman then. Now I am a warlord.
Bobby, you can't overlap with Dan's voices.
I love his voices so much.
We all love those goddamn voices.
First of all, not Gary.
Dan's Voice Academy,
son of a
backed
bitch.
By Jim McClure.
I'm sorry. Opening in two locations in West Village.
West Orlando. It's got to be crusty places. We're in West Orlando.
Odd spot.
It's Saskatoon.
Saskatoon.
Go ahead, play. This is her song.
I think this song.
Ow.
Jay just smashed his ear on the microphone.
Coffee or tea or be with me.
Oh, yeah, this is definitely it. She's never sad before.
Oh, my God, dude. At the playground. Also, if you're with your kid and she's trying to film this music video and you're just at the playground, you go, "Hey, lady, you're really bringing down the vibe."
How about they have to play the kid that dies?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, would they show the kid?
It's not the actual kid.
I know.
Yeah,
they did a Weekend at Bernie's with the real kid.
They tied string to his wrist and puppeteered him.
She goes, "I want you to use my son."
It's been,
but Lisa, he's been dead for 6 months.
I want you to use my son. And
movie magic, make it happen.
Put my turquoise necklace on his neck.
No, this my will revive him for 24 hours, but he will consume the flesh of humans.
I took this off a dead Indian chief.
No, I want to put this. And my name is Commander.
Commander Gale.
Commander Gale. Commander Gale, everybody that's a loser. Commander Gale.
Don't you hate bangs on an old woman?
Oh,
I love it.
Go play this. This is true.
Oh, this is sad.
It's a William Rivera joint?
It was Memorial Day.
Oh, God, it's immediately. Wow. Here's the thing. Wow. It's so sad. Wow. It's just immediately great.
Jay,
it's just immediately great.
Listen to
like,
me, dude.
This is a woman, this is a mother who's lost her child, and you're still like, oh,
I don't know if I can do this.
It was Mother's Day, the doodle day.
You've put me through enough. You've put me through enough yesterday, and I don't know if I can do
this. I went through it with you, dude.
You did?
I didn't ask you to do anything that I wasn't doing myself. I ask nothing of you that I wouldn't be willing to jump in the dirt and do with you.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I am well versed in Lisa Gale, and you have to see this.
Yeah, but at least you had Josh next to you like coke dancing the whole time.
Oh, was he really?
Yeah.
He
goes, you know what's crazy about it is I'm supposed to be sad, but Josh I don't. Said? I feel so good.
I'll tell you what Josh said to me yesterday. He goes, I'm watching it, dude. I get it now. I get the cure.
Oh.
I don't know what that means, but it made me laugh. All
right. Here we go.
Also, just on a slight note about concerts in general, everybody, unless you're sending a specific thing to be like, hey, mom, look, I filmed like 20 seconds of this song. It's that song. I don't understand how many people... you're making a shitty video that someone has already made, by the way, at the same show, from a better seat even. You're never going to use this again. It's such a waste. And everybody... no one does this, by the way. They don't film and watch the show. They look through... it's nuts.
Yeah, everybody around me was videotaping like they were making a documentary.
It's insane.
Except for the aliens. They were actually using their bionic eyes. I'm telling you, dude.
I think we had a special needs kid next to us because his parents were next to him. They did not seem to be into it at all, but he was super into it. But then he came back with a tall boy.
Josh goes, hey, Jay, this guy's super strong.
This guy keeps missing his mouth with the popcorn.
He came back with a tall boy at one point, so he wasn't too young.
Well, they have to sell. Technically, you do have to sell beer. Do you have to sell beer if, like, someone who's mentally retarded comes into the liquor store and they're
of age? Yeah,
100%.
But
they can't drink beer.
No, I know, but you just gotta feel bad if they're like, if they come in with a heavy order.
Yeah, if they put it in cereal, you gotta stop that.
Empty seats in front of us, and Josh thought about one point. He goes, "I think I'm gonna go down there." I was like, "Why?" I'm like, we're all like here, like talking about. He's like, man, I want to dance, man. Like, he meant it
to the Cure.
Yes,
the whole time I looked down.
To the Cure?
Dancing.
Yeah. Dude, and by the way, like, eyes closed. Like, he was feeling it, dude.
Is he on drugs?
There's two dances.
Yeah, not like heavy drugs of any kind now.
Dan, there's two dances at the Cure. There's the little arm flowing.
That's
like
fun.
Like water. And then there's the head. just the head. Where they just...
yeah. Was there any of this? Is there any of this?
Yeah, of course.
100%. That's the one
dance.
There was
also a guy in our row that looked like young Robert Smith.
I think like the only way you can dance a Cure is like this.
No. Can I explain an emotion that you might understand? This song, when this song came on, I know this song.
Sadness?
I know this song, and I don't like it. But because on pure familiarity, I was like, okay, okay.
Something I kind of, it's like when you see an American overseas.
Son of a bitch.
Hey, where are you from?
Dude, they held us hostage all night long, double encore. And then they played.
7 and 9 is fucking insane. Like 7 and 9 is, that is cruel.
It's hostage. Then they played that song and it's 20,000 people just quietly dancing with their heads. It's fucking a
duke. Duke-a-duke-a-duke. Turn this shit off. I gotta hear some more Lisa Gale. Now let this Lisa Gale thing play. It's gonna get to my Cure point.
Okay.
Very slowly.
Well, there's a lot of people talking, Lou. I'm trying to stay on board.
No, I'm saying Lisa Gale takes a long time to unwind this motherfucker.
Oh, yeah. Go back.
It was Memorial Day.
Why do we gotta go back?
Because I gotta hear that opening line.
Because we gotta know that William Rivera put this into the world. directed by
Billy Rivers?
Oh, the sound is off.
Billy Rivers?
Does he make an appearance in any of the videos?
Billy Rivera?
The husband?
No.
He's in a video talking with her on something.
Yeesh.
They're sitting and talking.
Like in the fucking. This is the same thing as we talked about.
Then he ditches her. Then he leaves her, and then she starts doing these crazy videos from her own like townhouse she lives in now. She's out of the mansion.
Yeah.
Bruce Leroy. Remember that movie?
Oh yeah, Last Dragon.
Last Dragon.
Same thing. I think we talked. Didn't we talk about this? With the he put himself in the videos with the girl.
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, Eddie Arcadian.
Eddie Arcadian.
He's like Eddie Arcadian.
This is what this is.
Yes.
Go ahead, play it.
Hit it.
It was Memorial Day in 1983.
Shout out.
God bless our troops.
I had a dream but didn't know it was for me.
Oh, God.
Things were about to change that I couldn't
inside
see.
Your mom's vagina. It sounds like a song, like a comedy song.
My little boy soon would be a memory.
Oh, damn.
Christ.
Look at her pushing the empties away.
That something went wrong.
How could you make me sadder than a Cure concert?
Yeah, she'll
this
do it.
This is terrible.
Dude, do you think your husband's like, do you have to do the song about the kid?
Is it his kid?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Oh, man.
No.
He's like, old lady, stop.
Here's Vincent.
Up in the skies, God, to tell me why. Did my only child have to die? Let me here on this earth to cry.
That shit. So... You can turn that off now.
Is that his real grave?
It better be.
Probably.
Oh my God. She put a real grave at the park next to a swing?
Or she's pouring it out.
If she's not, some guy's just standing off camera with flowers going, can I help you? That's my father's grave. Yeah, I was coming here to leave flowers for him.
Is there a reason you're singing to my nana?
Yeah.
I was stopping by to leave some flowers, and I noticed you're singing to my family member's grave.
It would look much finer inside your mom's vagina. Why did my child have to die? She's crazy. So when that links to the Cure, when the first encore started, he comes out, he goes, these next few are going to be a little bit tough, this next stretch here. He goes, this one's about my brother who passed away. And then I think the chorus is like, I'm so sad my brother's dead and drugs killed him.
Jesus.
Dan, it's so on the nose.
I had French fries already. I went and got more fries and then I dumped. I went into the bathroom to dump.
You took a dump.
I ate an inordinate amount of French fries last night.
Oh.
You just kept going
back.
We
just kept going and getting French fries.
Dude, I just kept going and getting French fries. It was the worst thing.
Did DeRosa love the concert?
Of course he did.
No, he didn't.
He loved it because he was around the... He told me they VIP'd him in.
There was somebody
waiting for them. They brought him in.
Dissension in the ranks, by the way.
Yeah.
I think me and Christine have been quietly phased out of the friends group over there. We've gone away.
Really?
With that group, with Ari and Sal and everybody.
Was it Ari, Sal, and DeRosa?
It was Jay. All of them.
No, wait a second. Jay.
Yeah?
You were invited. You said, no, I'm going to get my own tickets.
No, I didn't.
That's what DeRosa said. He said, you were invited, and you were like, no, I'm going to get my own tickets.
We did say that we had tickets already.
Yeah. You said you had tickets already. You were.
Well, Ari had tickets already too, and I think they told him to sell
like
his tickets.
Sal
they go, sell
anyway.
Your tickets and come with us to the.
Sal's like, guys, we got box seats. Like,
if just know this, know this. If you
will be there.
If you had sold your tickets and you told me last minute that you and Christine and Josh were going to be in a private booth with all them, and I was sitting,
you'd killed your family last.
Jay would have been the funniest person on the planet.
I would have killed all of you.
Yeah.
If I was at a Cure concert with Don and Max, without you.
Yeah.
Everybody would have died.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody will burn.
That's pretty cool. That guy over there is starting to kill people because his friend's up in the box.
This was fucking terrible.
How did Max like it? He liked it.
Dude, Max liked it too much, though. I looked over at one point, he had his hair in front of his eyes and he was playing the long neck bass.
Yeah, countdown backwards from 10 and I'll come on your face.
Oh, dude, I love that.
That was Ron Jeremy's thing.
You're going to be at a city club. You're going to be at a city council meeting trying to get Cure banned from schools because Max is a little sad kid now.
So
he's like, I don't want to go to the park.
I mean, the only part, I did like it because we, Don, and Max, when they started the hits, we were all kind of dancing together.
Okay.
We had a good time. I looked down at Jay.
27 songs in.
Crazy.
Yeah. We were older human beings.
That's crazy.
I looked down at Jay and Christine. We were all kind of having a good time at the end for around 14 minutes.
Well, I also have the set list up. You know my game. So I am trudging. I'm like, No. There's so many more. And then I know the last two. He's right. The most exciting part, they start doing Just Like Heaven.
Yeah.
Song 28.
Oh.
And song 29 was Boys Don't Cry, which I don't even like Boys Don't Cry.
I'll text message. I'll read a little. Can I just read a little about it?
Yeah. Let it go. Go off, King.
All right. It takes. Oh, here we go. Okay, here we go. I want to kill myself. There goes screen. You're at the. This is Christine. You're at the right show then.
Funny.
And then he's singing. This is at the beginning. The first guy. He goes, is that Dave Smith singing? It is. All right, ready? What is he saying? It takes more than a fucking someone. Ahoo, ahoo, ahoo. I wrote kill me. Then three. All right. Three seats in front of us. Come down. What's happening? Did they give up? No. Then the people in front, or whatever. Then it goes like this. Set two encores. I wrote no, exclamation point, exclamation point, exclamation point. Then he said halfway through, and Jay writes, ha ha, which I didn't think was funny. I wrote, are you leaving? And then he wrote, just to the bathroom. And then it just went down.
Did you guys have any, did either one of you think you were going to escape before the end?
No.
I asked every 8 minutes, do you want to go, to Max?
No.
Every 8 minutes, I went, you want to go?
Was Max the swing vote? Like, if you would have got Max, Don would have followed?
I can't leave without Max. Max is, he enjoyed it so much. I think it's the first time he got high, because whoever was around us was smoking some joints.
Really?
Yeah.
We were rows below you.
He got...
I was ripping butts. I was hoping they kicked me out. I found a pretty new fun way to smoke and not get caught.
What's that?
It just didn't work. After a while, it fills.
Just so let it out in sad size?
No. Got myself a White Claw.
Okay.
Light the cigarette, put the cigarette down on the White Claw, and just keep like you're sucking a straw. But eventually the can does fill with smoke, yeah. And you go, ha! And then the entire area smelled like stale cigarette. Yeah, so you know what? It wasn't a great idea, but for the first few pulls, though, I felt like I was really pulling something. And then by the end of the concert, I was smoking like...
But you're next to Josh, who's tugging on a vape pen, and the cloud of smoke around him is
plumes.
Like the weather changed.
And he's just going, man, I didn't know they were going to do this one. I haven't heard this one. He goes, I didn't like it, but this is
He always
great.
Goes... He goes, sorry.
It's. I was looking down at him, and it's like people vanished. Everybody around him just vanished.
Jesus.
Every tug of his
Do you
vape
think
pen.
There's someone that was sitting in the vicinity of you guys that was telling a Josh story today? That they're like, yeah, this guy was fucking vaping and dancing, and we're just trying to be sad.
I'm going to win them over because I'm good looking, I'm cute, I'm funny, I'm talented.
It's true. All those things are true.
All those things. I'll say this, though, for the sake of all of us, and it's true. I was in a skybox once for, it would have been great for The Cure because we could have like eaten and done stuff. No,
fell asleep.
Bullshitted and like, done whatever. It would have been great in that regard, but I'm telling you.
Had energy to stay through the rest of the show.
Oh, for a concert. Yeah, you could have got out and stretched your legs.
For a concert thing, we were in much better seats than a box.
I got to say, not for this shitty produced show.
No, because there's no screen, there's nothing.
Crazy there's no stage.
You could see that. You could see the stage fine. It was good sure. view of the stage,
maybe,
but
you can't see them. And they have like you know, everywhere you can look, and there'll be big monitors where you can watch. They had two literally like 100-inch
he doesn't want to be
plasmas.
Seen.
Rage Against the Machine had an awesome stage show.
Unreal.
And they had he had a broken foot, and it was still like
he sat on a box the entire show in Rage Against the Machine and
murdered.
Huge energy show.
Yeah.
Murdered.
Screen show. I mean, high production screen shows of all kinds of crazy shit.
And it's
loud
crazy
sound.
That The Cure doesn't. You would think The Cure would have like super sad videos to go with the super sad songs.
Max didn't go to school today.
He was too bummed?
Yeah, he was bummed out. He was too sad.
He goes, it's Wednesday. I'm at home.
What's the point in learning about what the sadness and the torture that this country is built upon?
I don't think you understand. I don't want to really go to school today.
Dad, I'm a cis white male. Yeah. I need to check myself.
I've caused too much problems in the world. Let me stay at home.
Christy, now I'm going to give you...
I'm excited for this.
I think one of the biggest laughs... of your week here, buddy, because this one...
I'm very excited.
This is going to make everyone happy. Christine, bring up the video I showed you. So, I looked this up, too, to see that... Hang on, stop it for a second.
This is nuts.
This is great. This is so crazy.
This is crazy.
So, I look... Actually, you can play, because it's long. But he's just playing.
I just want to say, this guy represents everybody at that concert.
He does. So he's the piano player. They said The Cure, there's only one member of the band who's been in the band like for like 30 years.
And that's Robert?
Two members. It's him and somebody else besides Robert Smith. Everybody else is a hired gun for sure.
Sure.
And this guy's the piano player, most of it.
Everybody else has committed suicide.
This is
in the band.
This is Boys Don't Cry. You're probably not wrong about that. I just go to show him wailing and just go back to the energy. I just want to show the difference in energy. How uninterested the tambourine. He's playing tambourine, the piano player now. And we'll put this out. I'll post this.
He's just smacking it just completely with zero.
At the Bonfire SXM. Now, Christine, hang on a second. How much time's left in this? Gang, 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 gang. Oh, yeah, you let it play. This tickled me so much.
Say it. Boys do cry.
Ugh. Boys cry when they're forced to watch 3 hours of The Cure, three-plus hours.
Look, shake it out. Watch this. Drop.
Flick.
Earplugs out.
Flick them.
Bye.
Damn.
He is clocking off stick, gone.
Out. Dude, that's clocking out of an Applebee's.
Did you see him drop the thing? He just goes.
Dude, go back to the drop.
Go back to the drop. Is the most, when I saw that, I was like, oh, dude, I finally pulled out my phone for the right moment.
Yeah, dude. No, wait, a little thing, before. Yeah, there it is.
Like, dun, 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 dun.
Fuck this place.
I mean, he's on Madison Square Garden stage. That's how much he hated that 30 songs. Yeah. Look.
Boom,
dude, the one-handed drop. He's like, get the fuck out of here, you sad puss.
He just lets it go. He just goes, yeah.
He goes, you guys can catch me over at O'Malley's. And I'm going to be getting fucked up.
He had to. He played one song on the fucking piano.
Yuck.
And he had to sit in the back in the dark and listen to this dribble for 3 hours.
It's dribble. Oh, man.
Everybody in the concert.
I hope he was playing like Candy Crush or something.
Everybody
you know,
in the concert
goes,
did
hey,
the
guys,
same
you're
thing.
Up. He goes, oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I got to play piano on this.
Dude, everybody did the same thing. As soon as they vroom, we went, fuck this. How
good did that feel driving home? You're like, oh, get this off.
Oh, when we finally got, we had to walk down, it was like the Empire State Building stairs. And wow. We went down some staircase. It was like a 20-minute exercise fitness routine.
I'll tell you this. When we got outside after the show and you just hit the air of outside, it was like, that was a great moment. I was like, yes.
Yeah.
It's done.
I was so happy.
He no longer has us.
And then I got into a yellow cab, the guy drove directly twice into the traffic of the tunnel.
That's
it was
sick.
Like he was chasing the tunnel traffic.
That's
it
fun.
Was insane. There was no reason to do it at all.
Dawn parked right near the garden. I was so, because I said, why don't you park over near the bonfire? We'll go up. She goes, oh, she called me last minute. I think I'm going to park near the garden because after this, we might want to just get in the car and just go right home. I kissed her so, I was like, I love you. I love you. So
good
much.
Good move. I'm so sad now.
If I had to walk through all that eyeliner and black clothing for any more time, I would have killed myself.
God, it really was a sad sack of shit in there.
Drea
DiMatteo was three rows in front of us, though.
Who's that?
Sopranos.
The girl that got killed in Sopranos. Chris's girlfriend got killed in
Sopranos.
Oh,
shit, yeah.
Yeah.
What the guy in front of you, though, is, I mean, he's the ultimate fan. I think there's a couple different. There's the fan who, my age, maybe older. Dude, we got to go see The Cure. And they get the wig. And dude, we'll wear wigs. We'll bring the wives.
The wig. There's definitely guys wearing Robert Smith wigs.
Yeah, and look at the wives are like.
But they were like, you know, like yeah, look, dude, I'm wearing the thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're those guys.
And their
guys,
wives
man.
Are like, you guys are idiots. Why are you wearing that? Because it's fucking The Cure. Yeah.
But then there was guys who had Robert Smith hair.
Yeah.
And the same make and makeup, crazy eye makeup.
Dude, that guy, those guys have been waiting for that concert. That's been on the calendar for a lot of those dudes.
Yeah, the guy
getting
was
ready
in front
to tease their hair.
The guy in front of him combed his hair with hay. It was disgusting. He hasn't washed his head in around 7 years.
Do you know Josh Adamyers has such a bad luck thing? His eye line, when everybody was sitting for the most part, one guy didn't sit. And it was directly Josh's eye line. And it was a scraggly white dude, older, balding on top, bald on top pretty much. And his side hair was very long and in dreads.
Damn.
Now, if you recall, last time we went to go see Korn all together, if you recall, a white guy with dreads ruined Josh's night there, too. Because
down the aisle.
The guy was like, Josh had to keep going, do you mind, man? Because the guy was just like corning out and slapping Josh with dreadlocks over and over again. Josh was like, come on, man.
Starting
so
to
much
hurt.
Empty seats down there. So the guy just kept getting closer and whipping him with fucking dreadlocks. Dreadlock white guys.
The Cure should be seen in an 80-seater.
They that's, should be
80 seats. The Pussycat Lounge is where the Cure should play.
Is it, I mean,
play the Garden and cut 12 songs off your set list.
Yeah, I would say 12? More than that.
12, yes.
I think this is their third night in a row playing MSG. Yeah. Tonight is.
They said
tonight's the second night of three.
They said they could have sold out two more shows. If they put tickets, yeah, they could have sold out two more shows.
What if they just
Well, they're already sold, so I feel comfortable saying it's not good.
It's not good.
Do you think there's anyone listening right now that has to go and they're like, fuck, just spent 25 minutes, 30 minutes just ripping that show apart and they're like, I gotta go tomorrow.
John Cougar Mellencamp was a little underwhelming when I went.
What about, okay, guys.
Lights, leaps and bounds, more entertaining of a fun show than The Cure.
Jay, Dan
Even Christine was having more fun at John Cougar Mellencamp, yes.
Jay, Dan Soder, friend.
Dan, your thoughts?
Quick question. What was worse, The Cure last night or Phil Collins?
Phil Collins. Because they played maybe three songs I know, and the songs I didn't know is like the worst era of Genesis. It's like they didn't do any. They did all Peter Gabriel Genesis.
Oh, really?
With Phil Collins singing, with the exception of like three songs. It was
that's weird.
So
as shit.
Shitty.
What's the worst? Is that the worst show you've seen?
Bar none.
Really?
Really?
Bar. Let me tell you something. I have my plantar fasciitis acted up.
Oh no!
Because you had a stand.
Yeah.
I was walking around so much.
I went to the bathroom at one point and just took a whack at spending some time trying to get an ingrown hair.
I went to the bathroom
on my leg.
I played Sudoku and Tetris twice.
Yeah. I was like, I gotta go to the bathroom and see if I can get something out of this thing. It's feeling a little tender down there.
3:45.
Dawn thought I was smoking weed with Jay. Because every time I saw him leave, I was like, I'll be right back. She's like, are you doing?
I'd get him.
Yeah.
I'd get it, Bobby. I go,
yeah, you go, Bobby. And yeah. Then just in the background on stage is him going.
Every time you listened, I would listen to see what song he was on. Because, you know.
It all sounded the same?
The same horseshit.
Three nights. Sold out.
By the way.
MSG.
By the second two times that I went out just to go do something out in the concourse, Christine followed also. I didn't go, hey, you want to go do something? She was just like, just behind us. She's like, I'm out here too. She didn't love it.
Dawn loves The Cure. One of her favorite bands. That's why when you said you're going to The Cure, I'd be like, oh, let me get him for Dawn. And Max would love him too, because, you know, and I didn't want to go, and then you forced me to go. You bullied me to go. And
bully's the wrong word.
Well, I mean.
Convinced.
You're bigger than me, and you made me do it. And
Sounds like you bowed down.
Look, sure, am I bigger, stronger, and faster? Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Fine, but that's not the point. That you're...
Well, it was also before the new teeth. Scarier.
Ooh. yeah. Well, don't worry. Dan almost took care of those for me.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You guys had a nice weekend together, didn't you?
That was scary.
So many smooches and hugs.
I was watching all your little fucking happy little cheating videos.
Oh, my God.
Why did my child have to die?
Jeez, give me a little more of that song, Christine. Let me hear the second verse.
I hate it.
Give me the second verse of the song.
Torturous.
I did. Oh, no. When you come back from break, we'll roll on a...
Jacob, hi,
no,
Jacob.
What about?
We haven't said hi to Jacob.
Oh, we haven't said hi to Jacob. We also haven't said happy birthday to DJ Lou. It's
happy,
his birthday.
Happy birthday, DJ Lou.
Yes. Hi, Jacob.
Come on, DJ Lou, turning 37.
Thank you.
Dude, spread your ass.
Am I finally up, Lou? You've had me down for 40 fucking minutes.
Oh,
damn.
My
Jacob
God.
And Todd coming in hot. Jeez. I love when you're hot in Florida, dude.
Jake
hot
fuck
in Florida.
What's
Jacob.
Your point, Jacob?
Is this a... Is this
That's his birthday present to himself.
Is this a solvable problem?
Well, I was playing The Cure music. And we
I know. I'm saying we have a lot of stuff. You're going to be playing stuff all the time. That's the nature of the show. Mm-hmm. Is there a way to not have Jacob on the same track as that?
Yes, but then I give him to Christine, and then when she's searching for stuff and I have Jacob's pod up, I might hear her searching for stuff. So her shit's gonna get
There's
on the
no
air.
Other choice than that, though. It's one
me
of those
or Christine,
two.
Christine, yeah.
Why is Jacob waving a gun in the video?
Because he's had it.
All right, Jacob. What do you want to say? Here's your platform.
Nothing. You missed some zingers by me. Whatever.
Shit.
It's the public's loss. Hi, Dan.
Hi, Jacob. How are you?
Jacob, you're gonna have to start All coming right. into the studio, I guess.
We gotta get an update with Jacob because those people have like 3 hours of air left in that submarine.
Oh yeah, Jacob. Dude, Jacob. No, 12 hours, a little less now, I guess.
Yeah, Jacob, are you all hands on deck? Are you like watching every development of this? Because this is I never thought of a more Jacob story than this.
I've been keeping the tabs. Didn't I call this? I've been calling this for years. Crazy to do what they're doing, having a...
Jacob, can I ask you a question?
Paying, yeah.
When they have the next sub that's going to go down and see the Titanic and the wreckage of this sub, are you going to go do that?
Yeah.
Are you going to go on that little adventure?
I mean...
Jacob's trying to save money so he can also jerk off while he does it.
They just keep going down. There's just wreckages of subs.
Oh, look at this. It's a six stacker.
Jacob, there's a rumor that they're in the Titanic, that they were in the wreckage, caught in the wreckage. Do you think that's true?
I doubt it. I think they lost communication
Jacob,
an hour and a half in, so that's like well above they were.
Now, do you think when they die, they're going to find that heaven like Kate Winslet, like where it's going to be Leo waiting on top of grand stairs?
I mean, that's how I want to be greeted in heaven.
Hey, Jacob, there's a rumor that a megalodon actually bit into the sub. Is that? Did you hear that?
Jacob, follow-up question. Dan Soder, are you pumped for the Meg 2?
Jacob, not Dan. Yes. Follow-up to the follow-up. Are you pumped if they do survive, and are you pumped for the movie that's going to follow this, starring The Rock?
There's going to be a movie.
Yeah, you're right.
How about 47 meters down, too? Even more meters downy.
I hate that they use meters.
Damn, dude. How much? I mean, it's crazy.
Even more downy.
It's crazy that there's a running clock on like how long these people have.
Less than 20 hours of air left.
But no,
I was listening to a DJ on Sirius today on one of the music stations when I was driving, and she was like, a lot of people are making jokes, which, by the way, I'm all, you know, make jokes about whatever you want. I don't give a shit. But she did go, she's surprised how freely people are making jokes about this. And it's like, they're going to die. They go, is it not being taken, like, people not feel bad because it's like a billionaire? It's like his son's also on there. You know what I mean? It's like, these are people.
He's a billionaire too, though.
Yeah, the kid that they were making fun of.
Oh, then it's fine. You're right. Let's laugh at it.
The stepson.
Why did Titanic search party have to die?
The stepson of one of the guys was at a Blink-182 concert and posted about it. I saw him catching shit for that.
Right. What happened? Who?
He said my dad would have wanted me to to feel good at this moment.
Yeah, and he went to a Blink-182 show.
Of course he did.
Girl, it's a rock show! And meanwhile, his dad's like, we gotta get out of here somehow. We're gonna fucking die.
I saw a story that the son, did someone, one of the other guy's sons, like, while this is happening, like, try to hook up with an OnlyFans model? I saw a story.
We had it
on Skanks today. We didn't get to the story, but it was like one of the people's, like, son tried to shoot a shot with an OnlyFans, like, girl, while the family's missing underwater.
That's fucking wild.
If your stepdad's a billionaire and he's in a sub and he's about to die and your mom's about to get a lot of money.
He goes, hey, Mom, I thought about you. Wait, hold on real quick. Where are you? And I'm so sorry. I cannot sleep. I cannot dream tonight.
Oh, Jacob, you're back out.
Oh, sorry.
Damn, the control.
Your point, Jacob? Sorry.
Oh, wow.
How are these people doing?
I was going to say, they played basically a double album for an encore.
Damn, yeah, that's a double album. That's 16 songs.
It's insane.
16 songs. Jacob, fucking nuts.
Yeah.
It's 15.
Jacob,
6 and 9.
Jacob, not
oh,
Dan.
Oh, I thought 7
not Dan,
nine.
I got another question for you, because you're the expert on this. They're going to die, from the cold before they die of oxygen, right? Because it's freezing down there.
It's cold, but they can survive till tomorrow, but it's going to be the oxygen. Even if they get to them, it's not like people think they're just going to put a rope around it and drag it up. There's not a lot of...
things that can get down and get to them.
Yeah, and the pressure down at where they are, too, might crush any... There's very few things that can get to it and then hook it up and bring it up. So it's a logistical nightmare if they do find it.
Did you guys ever think of the possibility of an underwater civilization that takes them in and heals them, and that's where they are right now?
That was Ralph. Sutton. He was one of the first people I saw after I heard that lady say it on the radio. Like, people were making a lot of jokes, but Ralph put that. He goes, do you guys think we're watching in real time the origin story of Aquaman? And you're like,
what?
I think they're going to die, Ralph.
Yeah, Ralph, they're going to die of oxygen.
You got to make a better joke than that if you're going to die.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Stepson shoots his shot with OnlyFans model as rescuers scramble to locate missing sub. Let me read it. Go up. This is great. He just reaches out. Hang on. Things are starting to look very grim for the five people trapped inside. I already read that with too much happiness. Things are starting to look pretty grim for the five people trapped inside the submersible. meant to explore the Titanic, but that's not stopping the stepson of one of the missing men from shooting a shot with an OnlyFans model. Damn. It's his stepdad. Hamish Harding is a British billionaire among the passengers inside Ocean Gate's Titan, the submersible that lost communication 2 hours into its dive Sunday. Harding's stepson, Brian Zazz's, has been very...
You got nailed it. Nailed, nailed it. You nailed it.
He's all consonants.
You fucking nailed it.
S-Z-A-S-Z. Zazz's.
That's one of the songs they sang last night at the
fair. Zazz's song. Fuck, that concert sucks shit.
I want my life back. I want my son back.
Do you know what really hit me yesterday? Because we landed Monday. We had no show. We had no show here Monday, but I landed and did have to get my shit together relatively fast and go do Legion of Skanks. Came home yesterday. We have to do two bonfires yesterday. And I feel like I had to do something before that. Maybe not. Maybe that was the first thing. But came to do two bonfires and then this concert. Today I woke up at a dentist appointment. I did Legion of Skanks already. I'm doing this. I'm doing SDR. So then I got a pack to go back out on that tour.
Jesus.
And I really, when we got in the cab yesterday, I fought. This is good. You'll appreciate this, Christine. I fought almost starting a fight with Christine just to get out the anger that I've wasted my entire night. But I didn't. And then Christine goes, we really got to make sure you keep your Tuesdays off during this tour. I'm like, yeah. Yeah, that was a lot.
I have to go tonight.
We got back. It was 12:45.
I got back at 1:30, starving, by the way. And then I woke up this morning and everybody was like, fuck you, we're not going to school. Dawn didn't wake up. The dog was like, fuck off.
Wait, really? Everyone was just in a cloud of malaise?
Everybody was just...
A general malaise?
Yeah, I have to go tonight. I have to do this. Then I have to go tonight and get... I got to get... I'm getting in at the Italian-American Club.
What?
I have to go get initiated at the Italian... What are you laughing at?
I remember. What? Wait, Bobby That's told me this before the show. I asked him if they get initiated, do they slap him with spaghetti noodles like when Brazilian jiu-jitsu people get slapped with the belts?
I have to go tonight, and I'm getting initiated into the Italian-American Club.
Robert Kelly's going to be a made man.
What's that face, Jay?
You're not really Italian.
I'm half Italian.
But
Sicilian.
Why did you really... You upped it on the Italian.
I'm half Italian.
You take Jay and I to have little espresso?
You can come to the Italian as my guest.
Can I play some bocce ball?
24 hours a day. Can come play a little bocce. You can smoke a cigar.
I want to play some bocce ball.
You can have a little alozelle. You can have a little como se llama.
I don't even think that's real.
It's real. Como se llama.
Como se llama is how's your head, I think.
What's your name?
What is your name?
Please say that at your fucking little...
Jay, don't be a stunatz, okay?
Bobby's going to walk in tonight and go... Oh shit!
Ah, damn it! Oh no! And then it's you banging a payphone in Queens.
No!
Turns out they got Bobby. He had messed with a made man. Robert Smith was made, and he was in The Cure. Bobby had said some bad stuff about him.
Tonight's a big night, baby.
Damn,
8:15. I'm gonna be at the Italian American Club.
At 8:16,
I can never be made because of my Judaism. You see, but we were all kind of getting made that day because they were taking Bobby.
Hey,
you know,
Jay, tucking your cross of David there, whatever the fuck that is.
Bobby knew he was gonna be made, and he was happy about it.
Oh shit, dude!
Kid.
Oh shit, dude!
But it turns out that the mob had heard him talk about Robert Smith.
I gotta do. They having a meatball competition in a couple weeks.
Shut the fuck up!
I swear to God, they have a meatball competition, and Don's. I'm gonna enter.
They're gonna make Bobby do like the new guy stuff. He goes, go slice the garlic with a razor blade.
Maybe you heard.
I need you to go find me some fresh tomats and put down a bet on the Mets.
Hey,
right?
Maybe you heard it. Yeah. I don't do that no more.
Okay? Dane, I don't know if you heard this no more. I don't tourgasm no more.
Yeah, I don't tourgasm. You guys do the bird thing. I don't do that bus shit no more.
Hey, Stu Nod. Yeah. Hey, Stu Nod, no one buys crushed tomatoes in this place. Hey,
you two don't understand. I don't make forced videos. I'm an influencer by myself now.
You're ruining all my fun.
Yeah, that's right.
You're ruining all my fun.
Marcus Silva.
Shout out Marcus Silva.
You go and then you break a rule.
Get out of my face right now, man. I'm serious. I'll fucking knock you out.
Give him the one.
The rule. Hang on. This is terrible.
The funniest.
Fucking thing I'm doing, you have to somehow get in and break a rule. somebody was saying something.
Oh, man. These are some good drops, dude.
We have to talk about, because you guys are on Tourgasm right now.
Basically.
Oh,
for
you
sure.
You guys are tour guys.
I'm Jay Davis.
Too. You're Jay Davis.
I'm Gary Goldman.
You're Gary, and you're
Jay Davis.
You're Bob.
No, you're not.
You're Jay Davis.
No, I'm Bobby. You're Gary.
Me and Dan, I think, brought this up the other day because we were talking about how Jacob's watching Tourgasm. Again, the concept of, and none of you guys stepped in.
The BTK
to even just say
bit.
The fact of that, because the joke was he'd say. People say I'm so nice. I'm so nice all the time. This is Jay Davis's joke in Tourgasm. That's like the through line of the show.
Is that they're all Bobby, Gary, and Dane are all helping
they're
Jay
gonna
with
get this joke.
Bit.
You're so good at context.
You know what?
I started that. Well, no, I started that.
Jay?
Bonfire context.
Jay, calm down.
A little bonfire context.
A little bonfire.
Sometimes Jay gets upset if you steal credit.
Can I say something,
and
Jacob?
That's exactly what's happening right
Jacob,
now.
Jacob, I know you're a furious man right now, but I started giving the context.
You did.
You did.
That was great context. Yes. Yeah. No, I give you full credit.
It's great.
I'm just saying that he summarized it.
He did a good job summarizing.
I didn't fuck it. I love you got fired up about it. I context that.
He goes, Dan, you're so good at that. He goes, what the fuck I started doing?
First of all, Jim actually told them we don't know how to do this. He's actually bad at it.
Can I ask Christine to kill the screen share? She had me looking at the saddest picture of Robert Smith for 40 minutes. On top of my mic being down, I was ready to blow my brains out.
Dude, they took away your ability to speak and showed you a sad old British man.
Oh, it was so depressing.
Did you see Jacob hang himself with the blind rope?
But that great context.
What were you saying about it? Go ahead. What were you saying?
Well, hang on. First, I just want to say that Marcus Silva said he loves The Cure. Saw them in San Diego a few weeks ago. Had to leave an hour, and it just went on and on. Enough already.
It's terrible.
That's exactly
they are
right.
Fucking jerking each other off on that one.
Yeah.
No band's got 30 good songs. They don't have 15.
No. Yeah.
Terrible.
It
terrible
was so
concert.
Bad.
Terrible.
Very, very.
And no production.
What was the point I was saying? Where was I?
You were talking about Tourgasm, about the joke, and we never stepped in. I got you.
The fact that not
context.
Even on, thank you.
You're good.
Even on
not Dan.
No one corrected on the most basic level the flaw of the wording of the joke from no one ever said anything about this. When he goes, I'm so nice that if I was the BTK killer, they would call me the TLC killer.
And which immediately
like, no, they wouldn't because you'd be the BTK killer.
Yeah.
Like, can I say something right now in defense of moi?
Yeah. You didn't give a shit.
No, number one.
Number one,
they cut out a lot of stuff that I did say. Number two, I made him cry.
Okay.
Okay.
Fair enough.
I don't know what you want from me.
Let's not forget.
I did what I was supposed to do.
Let's not forget. I made him cry.
I made him cry.
Yeah.
He didn't even cry when Dane yelled at him for breaking rules.
Dane is a fierce competitor.
Oh. I know.
Do you have the apology part where Dane and he goes, I got to apologize to Jay. I said a lot of mean things to him.
Saying some of the things that I was saying to Jay, I probably would have been like, you know what? Whether I fucked up or not, dude, shut the fuck up or I'm going to come over and knock you out.
He goes, Jay really sat there and took it like a bitch. And I'm sorry for treating him like a bitch that he is.
Meanwhile, Dane, I know this for a fact, has not been in a fight in his life.
Ever.
Like you to knock somebody out is not an easy task. By the way, you can say it.
Yeah,
but to hit. You know
did he have security or something? I have a feeling the way he was famous, I had a feeling like boyfriends are gonna get pissed because I mean women are.
You mean parents?
I mean,
I'm sorry. I'm kidding. That's alleged.
But you know what I'm saying though, like
yeah, he had to have a good security team.
Thank you, Jacob.
Oh no, I'm loving it.
Where boyfriends were like, "Yo, fuck this guy. I'm sick of my chick. Like, you know, she's sending pictures of her tits blindly to his MySpace every day."
Yeah, you're gonna say Tourgasm when it was colleges. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
it
yeah.
wasn't the next phase of his life was arenas, which was stupid.
He went colleges to arenas.
I played the Garden with him in the round. Like I was there last night. Way more entertaining show by the way. I mean, people left happy. we did colleges. There was girls, but they were all, you know, college chicks and stuff like that. And there was no really banging on the bus because we did the show, 4-hour meet and greet, and then we left. But we got to take a break. We have to go. We got to pay the bills here on Sirius XM 103, Faction Talk,
and then
the Bonfire.
Come back with a song about Robert Smith's brother.
Yeah. Dan Soda's here. Dan, we got Dan Soda. He'll be in New York Comedy Club in Stamford. Great club, by the way. You're going to love
it. Excited.
July 7th and 8th. You got to go check him out. Beautiful, brand new club. And he's one of the funniest guys walking. After that, he'll be in Tampa What is that?
Dania Beach.
Where is that?
Dania Beach. It's Fort Lauderdale. It's the old. It's instead of being in the Seminole Hard Rock now, it's like
San Diego, Irvine, California. For tickets and all of the tour dates to see this funny young man, DanSoda.com. One of my favorite people in the world, and that's coming from not Dan. And we got Big J Oakerson. Big J, he's on the Fully Loaded tour. He's doing Tourgasm 2 all summer long. July 10th through the 12th, Legion of Skanks will be on tour in New Hampshire, Boston, Connecticut. For tickets and all other tour dates, visit BigJComedy.com. And you just go to RobertKellyLive.com. I'm going to be doing my summertime fun time tour all over New Hampshire, Rochester, Rutherford, New Jersey, and Las Vegas. So go to RobertKellyLive.com for my tickets. We'll be right back.
Also, listen to all of or follow all of us on social media and another. Subscribe to all of our YouTube channels. We don't push that shit enough.
Yes.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yes, please. Yeah. Fucking please.
Yeah, and leave some nice comments.
Leave some nice comments. Please. And listen to our podcast. Yeah. Listen to the Bonfire podcast
this
as well.
This is the Bonfire. We'll be right back after this. So haunting every time.
Yeah. What? Yeah. Guys, we're all looking for ways to make our lives better. Maybe a pre-workout before the gym or supplements to grow your hair. So why not take something that's already good, sex, and then make it better for you and your partner? That's what you get with the chewables from BlueChew.com. BlueChew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis, but in chewable form and at a fraction of the cost. And now they also have Vardenafil, mint-flavored chewables with the active ingredient in Levitra and Staxin, so you can stay hard and fresh. Blue Chew is an online prescription service, so no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in line at the pharmacy. And it ships right to your door. Oh, he's got a full hand of it. It's in a discreet package. Sign up at Blue... go higher on it. And feel where it's like actually strong. Feel high, yeah.
Nice. What
about this? No, don't. I'm not taking Blue Chew yet. Hey, you can get to consult with one of their licensed medical providers. And once you're approved, you're going to receive your prescription within days. Sign up right now, again, at BlueChew.com. And you visit BlueChew.com and try it for free when you use the promo code BONFIRE at checkout. Only $5 shipping. How cool is that? $5 for boners? That's BlueChew.com, promo code BONFIRE to receive your first month free.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
This is Ali Siddiq, and you're listening to The Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Robert Kelly on The Fraction Talk 103.
From the top of the Empire State Building, New York.
What the hell do you think you were listening to?
Thank you.
This is that shit ass song I was telling you about his brother. Why did my brother have to die?
Someone should mash it up.
That's what he said. He goes, something wicked this way comes to steal away my brother's life.
I feel like Jacob, dude. Is this how cold you guys keep the studio all the time?
Yeah, it's always cold.
I've done nothing. I've touched nothing.
Christine, you gotta make it warmer in here. It's fucking freezing in here.
I think it's the chair.
What they just pat? Like,
it might be the chair.
You're right over the... He's right over the vent. Yeah. Zan finally in.
Jacob, stop screaming over Zoom. You're like really worked up. You're so furious.
How would I know about that?
Every time we turn you up, he's like, hey, you fucking assholes over there in the studio.
Florida attitude. Screaming.
Go shoot iguanas, you psychopath.
Jacob,
I'm not screaming.
Jacob, you
that
have passion.
That was Luke Fader work.
This friend of yours about to die in a bubble in the ocean.
Fucking pussy.
Whoa.
Those dreamboats you love are about to eat shit in the
except right now, Lou, the best drop in the world works perfectly when Jacob's on Zoom. It's my favorite. If he can get it right, Lou can convince you that Jacob just dismissed what you said.
What is it? I like when Jacob's his little sex thing when he comes. Mm-hmm. Oh, my favorite.
Yeah.
I try to come like that now. Don's like, you almost done? I go...
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Yep.
And I was like, yep.
And I was like, yep.
Yep.
Fuck yeah.
Context.
It's a new bonfire. Dan, that's a woman who's getting fucked by her husband while discussing.
He knows it.
You showed it to me.
I know.
His balls, his head, his everything.
His everything?
Everything?
Yeah.
He's just giving you the news. He's showing off for you right now.
I like it, dude. Fucking solo.
Ozempic.
It's the jam, dude.
No.
This and Sky Rizzy have the two best hits.
Lou, are you about to fucking crush a Mountain Dew surge?
I don't know what it'll do. What will it do to me?
Is it alcoholic Mountain Dew?
Yeah.
Rip it, dude. I would. Dude, oh my god, I've never felt more jealous than right now.
You've ripped into a Mountain Dew. Get into a dizzy.
Why are you looking at me?
I was burping because of the snacks.
Hard Dew.
What is it? Does it taste like Mountain Dew? Oh, that did not look good.
It tastes like...
Four Loko?
Blackberry brandy and Mountain Dew.
Let me take a sip.
No.
I know, just testing.
That was not cool.
Bobby wants to get back in the game.
Not on my watch, pal.
Bob, if Mountain Dew... Alcoholic Mountain Dew brought Bobby back. That would be the funniest thing.
Oh, it'd be a violent. It'd be a violent comeback.
He's just bloody. He's beat the shit out of everybody in here.
It's funny. You see a trail of hard Mountain Dews on the floor. On the way, goes. Oh no.
No, no.
Oh, Bobby got into the stash. Hey, Melissa.
How's the Ozempic going? Side effects?
Side effects like nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea may lead to dehydration, which may worsen kidney problems.
I mean, the news.
You know how I get. Don't do that.
Stop Ozempic and get medical help right away if you get a lump or swelling in your neck, severe stomach pain, or an allergic reaction.
That is fucking crazy. That you have those drops. That would fucking send me flying.
Bobby and Jacob are also sending like articles about bad side effects.
Because we care about
By
you.
By the way, the one Jacob sent today was.
I want no. I want you to be alive.
The one, Jacob, you want to be alive and fat or dead and thin, dude?
I don't know. You guys go back. Just go back to CrossFit.
Don't think about yourself for
a
second.
Party.
Just go get your stomach taken out like BK.
Yeah.
Dude, you're referring to yourself as BK. It's so fucking stupid and awesome at the same time.
Christine, I'll tell you something we haven't batted around. We're injecting each other's bellies with this Ozempic. Maybe instead, let's do the needles and suck things out of our bellies.
Oh, lipo?
And see if that works.
Dude, listen to me, Jay.
No, I'm saying with just the syringes, just see if we can pull something out, too.
Dude, just go get the belly taken out.
I don't want to go under if I don't have to.
Dude, it's a day. You're done. Next day, you're walking around.
You're eating soup. Yeah, I looked good.
You're eating bone broth. I'm sucking on a fudge.
I looked into a cosmetic thing a while back, and I didn't go because of the amount of paperwork they slapped in front of me. The biggest paperwork thing was saying, like, my family won't do anything if you kill me with anesthesia.
Yeah. Do this. I'll do all the paperwork for you.
That's smart.
I'll fill it all out for you. You just show up the day of surgery. Mm-hmm. Get your half your stomach taken out. Ba-boom.
Bang, bang, boom.
I don't
bang,
know if I'm next overweight thing, you know. Genuinely, I don't know if I'm overweight
damn,
enough for them.
Dude.
This is a tough answer.
This hurts, doesn't it?
I'm gonna say this to you, Jay.
I don't think he is. I don't think he's big enough.
You might be right. But
I think Jay's like, Jay's like 3 months of CrossFit classes from being just you're absolutely jacked. Get off the Ozempic.
Yeah, look at that. Oof.
Get off the Ozempic, dude. Get off the needle. You guys are better than the needle.
I mean, you got new teeth, dude. You're perfect the way you are.
Why? Because me and Christine, Christine did point out the lack of sexiness, though, in both of us, because you have to go and just grab your gut fat and then while the other person stabs you in it.
Really?
Christine did not feel good.
I would never.
I saw her face. Oh, she was really like.
If Dawn ever said, hey, can you put this needle in my gut? I'd be like, I'd never fuck her again. I'll do it, but we'll never have sex again.
I'd be like, we have to do heroin. If I do this, we have to do heroin.
Can you grab my gunt and stick a needle in it? That's terrible.
Aside from the article I sent you, that it has the phenomenon of creating flat butt and flat face.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're losing. Jeff Cavalier says the problem with Ozempic is
you're losing fast.
Jeff, you're losing muscle also. So God help you. If you ever go off of this, you're going to have less muscle. So that means that weight can go back on fast, because muscle is what burns fat.
Oh,
well, not if you exercise still.
When was you gonna? Are you exercising now?
We push-ups and sit-ups, exercise
every day.
No, but I want to do weights again.
I'm going to buy you. Can I buy you guys something for the apartment? A little, the band thing? That's
bands.
A push-up thing? Okay, I want that. I mean, you're one of those
guys.
That's
a nice offer, though.
I mean, just accept a gift. Say yeah and throw it out. I'll never check.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
I mean, the reason you're on Ozempic is because it works fast, right? And it's, like, effective, and it's the Hollywood
it's not even that it
works. Chic drug.
I'm not on it because it works fast. I'm on it because it works, generally speaking. I don't know how fast it's going to work.
Ozempic! God, what a fucking jam.
He's doing it for
Big Pharma's got the jams right now. This and Sky Rizzy. Do you know the Sky Rizzy joint?
No.
Nothing is everything.
Yeah.
It'll spin your fucking head, dude. It's beautiful.
The side effects don't affect you at all. That stuff is popping out. It doesn't even affect you, right?
What's popping out?
The article that your face is going to look like an elephant's
knee. I thought it was about ass. Your ass looks like that.
Your ass looks like what?
Is you're going to get pancake ass, but I came into the game with pancake ass.
Ah, you were born in the shadows.
I was born in that game.
Molded by it.
I was born.
The flat butt
there you go.
Belongs to me.
Yeah, I wasn't looking to get a fat ass from this.
Dude, I wish. I wish you had a fucking big old dunk.
There was a woman in Starbucks when me and Christine were in Starbucks.
Ozempic
before
butt. It's called Ozempic
I
butt.
To see it.
When me and Christine went into Starbucks on the way here, there was a woman in there wearing pants, full coverage pants, that I can only describe as pornographic, Christine. I mean, I've never seen it. They went in her ass. Like, you could have convinced me that maybe she had them painted, you know, when people do that, but they were pants, but I've never seen that. They were up her, like, meant to be, like, up her ass crack. Pretty wild.
Damn. Just pretty in the
hot.
Store?
I stared. I didn't even like when she left the store. I was facing the door. Like, I didn't even look. Christine was behind me getting the drinks together, and I was just looking at her ass. I'm like, I think this is why you did it, right?
Yeah.
You don't wear pants like that. Going like, what are you staring at?
Was it a nice ass?
It was a big. It was a big, huge BBL. It was a big BBL. But it was like, yes, on its own. Yes, it was a nice ass. Yeah, I saw this already. Here's what it is.
What does it look like? I want to know what Ozempic butt looks like.
The picture's uninteresting, because you're going to see a woman who's just like, doesn't have like a J-Lo ass, I guess?
I think it's because they lose weight so dramatically, everything just looks...
Yeah, Jacob, that's the other thing too. These are coming from people also too who are coming. That you got to remember, this is really given to like... We were talking today, like Zach Amico. Zach Amico should get on this.
He should do what I did.
Sure.
Zach should not do Ozempic. He should do 100% do what I did.
He's probably good for the medicine of the diabetes, too. I mean, Zach is like...
He could do both.
You're telling him double down?
He needs to do everything he can possibly do.
Double up. Double up, dude.
Guys, Zach, they're going to give you the works.
I've had a talk with Zach. I mean, a serious, you know... Man-to-man, because I did a horror movie with him.
Yeah, Spook Show. Zach Amico Spook Show.
Easy.
Midnight Spook Show.
That's not what I did.
Okay.
But
GasDigital.com.
What's your problem with Spook Shows?
Nothing.
What do you got to fucking say about that?
Nothing. I love Spook Shows.
Whoa,
what the fuck are you talking about?
But you talked to him?
What? I had a talk. I had a talk with him about it. I was like, dude, you gotta, because he had a hard time standing during the scene. I mean, to do the lines, like in between lines, he had to sit down.
Yeah, he's fucking hilarious too.
He's the best. He's so talented too.
Yeah, no, he's great.
And he's the one of the sweetest human beings ever for being one of the most vicious roast joke writers out there.
You know what would help him out?
Ozempic.
Dude, I think he just needs to get on the Sky Rizzy.
For his moderate to severe plaque psoriasis.
Yeah, dude. I think he needs to work on that moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. Dude, goddamn, this song fucking rules.
Let's hear it.
Nothing is everything.
Free to bare my skin, thanks to Sky Rizzy.
Oh, this is a different version of it, but it still slaps.
I'm celebrating my clear skin.
That's good.
It's different though. They changed it up, but they always keep the hook.
That's good.
Oh, I like consistency.
Right here it is though. But here it is.
It's not an Ozempic.
It's not an Ozempic. Well, it just wrote the banger of the summer.
I mean,
it's a cover. So let's chill. This is original.
It's not a cover, Dan. It's a parody satire. Yeah. Ozempic's the Weird Al Yankovic of TV medicine.
Weird Al Yankovic of Big Pharma. And this is fucking. Sorry, this is the Bob Dylan of Big Pharma.
Yeah, Sky Rizzy.
This isn't hit me like Ozempic.
I'm telling you,
it's
nothing
not
is everything.
Like Ozempic, because also the problem here is like you don't see the problem. Like, Ozempic starts talking to you about the. I like that they give you that. Goes, and maybe you'll even have a little weight loss. That's what they say. They go, and maybe. You might even lose some weight loss.
Maybe you'll look like Thor in 6 months.
Maybe.
Maybe you'll have abs.
Maybe.
Listen, who knows?
Who knows?
You may even lose a little weight.
Hey, I don't know. Maybe if you don't have diabetes, you can expect this as like weight loss. Yeah.
Maybe if you're pre-diabetic, it will help you, but maybe.
But they don't show one person.
Might be hot.
In Sky Rizzy commercials, they don't show one person with scaly lesions all over their
skin.
They
show the
redness.
They
don't show you moderate to severe.
And then they clear it up. Because I'm going to tell you right now, moderate to severe plaque psoriasis? Jay, it's a big deal.
But they never clear it all up. Do you ever notice that? They always leave a little bit of redness because it doesn't work.
Because they want show it to on manage people. Your expectations.
They do a little bit.
Not on people that I've seen. They always show it.
Guys,
like
I didn't come on here to have Sky Rizzy bashed.
Well, what? I feel like you did. You set yourself up for it, dude.
I mean, you said it was comparable to Ozempic. And
made the hit, which wasn't that. I don't know why Lou's sandbagging me. The real Sky Rizzy hit?
You call that a fucking Ozempic
that's
level
not,
hit?
Are you out of your... I mean, Dan, I love you, but that's not Ozempic.
That wasn't the real one, and I'll find the real one, and I'll shove it
what
up both your butts.
What have you been doing since you left this show?
Taking Sky Rizzy nonstop.
You'll notice that my moderate to severe plaque psoriasis.
You'll notice I don't look like a lizard with my shirt off anymore.
Is this the version?
Is this it?
Yes, that's it. Learn how AbbVie could help you save.
And fatigue. And is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses. Sky Rizzy attaches to and reduces a source of excess inflammation.
Look at that.
That can lead to skin.
That girl shaves. You can see beside her bathing suit. Now that she doesn't have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, she doesn't have to grow her bush over her big scaly lesions.
Her fucking serpent skin.
She goes, guess who's shaving their pussy again? And those purple gashes are gone.
Nothing is everything, Jay.
I gotta be honest. It's not hitting me.
All right, well, then it's not for you.
I don't know.
Let me hear it against Ozempic again. Lou, juice me up.
Ozempic is a fucking...
Oh, Ozempic.
I mean, yeah, I think Ozempic is... But it's based on a hit.
Make me believe I can shop at the mall.
Oh, eventually.
Oh, man. Big Pharma Rock, this is a hack.
This is great.
You gotta write your own shit.
Oh, yeah. Okay, fine.
Whatever.
Whatever you say, dude. I guess Amish Paradise sucks also.
No, dude, you know I love the... You know I love the...
The Yank?
You know I love the Yank.
You know I'm all about the Yank.
Oh, man. Well, just don't get flat butt, because both of you have great, wonderful round butts.
Who does?
Jay has a flat butt now.
Flat ass already.
I have a flat ass, too. That. I lost my ass when I
don't know
when
if
I
Christine's
did,
defining
weight,
feature is her ass.
When I did the weight loss, I lost my butt.
You did?
My butt's bad now, but I'm working on it. You can work on your butt. Yeah,
Christine's never been a butt person. She's more of a huge hoots gal.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Christine got a good butt.
Christine's all tit.
Tit, one tit. She's one tit.
She's one cumulative tit separated into two.
What's the end game? How long are you guys going to take this for?
You have to take it for 9 months.
I think the rest of our lives.
If they get off it before 9 months, one of them will die.
What?
Yeah.
That's fucking
it's in the song.
Crazy.
Listen like to the song.
You're not listening to the lyrics.
I swear to God.
Oh, you're only listening to the commercial version. You're going to hear the whole thing. It's fucking dark. Pretty dark in there.
It's pretty fucking dark and twisted.
It's not, murky. You have to do 9 months, right? 9 months?
No.
How you have to do
rest
a certain
pregnancy.
You have to do. Did you read the directions?
No.
Did you guys get this from like Dr. Nick Rivera in The Simpsons?
You can stop whenever you want.
I don't think that's true.
100%
for decades. Because like if you have bad side effects or anything, you just go off of it. And they said also you like say you lose 30 pounds in whatever 4 or 5 months, you can go off of it and see if you can maintain without the drug. It's just a lot of people like don't change their habits.
Yeah, it's like
while
the dumbest. Again, it's like the wording of things that are always like get people worked up. It's like. As soon as you go off it, you're going to gain the weight right back. Like, sure, if you go back to eat, yes, if you eat with bad habits, you will definitely go back. But if you eat normal as you've been eating for whatever months you've been on the thing,
to get
fine.
You to the point where you have to use Ozempic.
Yeah. And then you could always go back on, he said, if you want or whatever.
Right.
But I don't plan on being it forever. But I do like give myself, every time I shoot up Christina, I treat like I'm Drago. I let the one little drop come out of the needle first, and then I jam it in.
Everything he eats, he burns.
He burns. Christina, I tell you what, though, the two needles I've given her, first two needles I've ever given in my life, it's really scary.
It's hard, right, to stick somebody with
it's,
something?
I got it now. I got it. Like, I got it, and it doesn't, I feel like she doesn't have a reaction of pain when it happens, so it's like, it's not scary anymore, but inflicting
you've
that.
Taken Dude, that
you guys
taken
have to play this,
her.
Yeah, you guys should play this song while you're sticking each other.
And then show Christine lifting me in a wheelbarrow.
What if your guy runs out of junk? What if you guys run out of a supply? What are you going to do?
You have to get Ozempic.
Bootleg Ozempic in Times Square.
You got to go to Mexico.
He's walks by and goes, Ozempic. I got Ozempic.
Yes. Give me a little bit.
Give me a little bit. Give me a shot.
Hey. I'll tell you, I'm checking my blood work inconveniently away from quitting everything. I was on testosterone for a minute. And then they were like, you got to come in for blood work before we give you a re-up. And I'm like, yeah, that's like way out of the way. I guess I'm just off testosterone now. Yes,
you think so,
Doc?
I'm sorry. You were doing tea too?
You didn't know that?
Before. That
he was
before.
On the, he was on the juice, dude.
What did that do? Because everybody's telling me
nothing.
Now.
I didn't think that, but
testosterone is going to be a problem.
I was on it for a month.
What do you mean it's going to be a problem?
That's not true. Bert's taking it. He's loving it. Bert, by the way.
Shoulder and back.
Is fucking like.
His shoulders and back.
It's crazy.
Like, Jesus. You on testosterone, you get out. You get too alpha again.
What the fuck are you talking about?
See? And I'll tell you where they won't appreciate this attitude is that your new little clubhouse with the Italians.
No, they love that shit.
They expect it, you cocksucker. Yeah. Hey, Bobby's here.
I go, Bobby, you're being a little aggressive. Are you on Sky?
How long have you been, what do they call it for motorcycle clubs?
Oh, yeah. Are you oh, fuck, what's it called?
Do you have your prospect? How long have you been prospecting?
Yeah. 6 months.
Do you have a bottom rocker?
Bobby tried to get out of the city early one night because he wanted to swing by for like some kind of bonanza they were having at the Italian American.
They had
club.
A
meatball tasting.
Go ahead, it was a game night.
A gabagool tasting?
It's a game night.
Was game.
It's
pin the tail on the fucking
stunads. No, they all the guys who killed.
Dude, I've been fucking listening. I've been coming out to this song.
Really? Papa loves Mambo.
This song fucking rules.
All the guys who kill animals, the deer, elk.
Ooh, that's
they
fun.
Have a, they put they bring all their meat down to the restaurant.
Oh yeah,
Casaletto's.
Oh, Casaletto's owned by Paulie Casaletto.
It is Paul Casaletto.
Is
yeah,
it really?
Yeah, it's Paul Casaletto.
These fucking gins.
And they're
all the fucking.
He takes the meat.
Turning to you. These fucking ginzos and their meat.
Papa loves Mambo.
And they take all the meat and they make dishes with it.
That's pretty awesome.
And then everybody goes, like 60 guys, and everybody goes, and they have all kinds of
what's the fees?
Bobby Misty drove by, and they were shutting the lights off.
I did. I missed it.
He missed his deer meatballs.
I was bummed.
What's the fees per year?
$200 a year for the Italian-American Club.
What do you do there?
You go.
Is it a cigar club also, basically?
It's a 24-hour place that you can go. I'm going to find out. I haven't been initiated.
Six months? They don't tell you anything?
I'm getting initiated. Well, I joined 6 months ago. I haven't gone. Because I'm a member of the Cigar Lounge, Cigar Republic,
mm-hmm.
which is my 24-hour cigar lounge. It's up the street, which you'd love. You'd love hanging out there. So I usually go there. But in the summer, they all go to the Italian American Club because there's an outside with TVs and they hang out on the back and everybody's over there. So I was
How do they check if you're Italian?
You have to whack somebody.
Yeah, you gotta kill somebody.
And you gotta make a sauce.
You gotta make a sauce and kiss your mom.
They ask you how you make a sauce. You don't have to make
how much you love your mother.
They check your lower back hair.
Yeah.
They check your tramp stamp diamond of ass hair.
Just enough. You're in.
He runs through and goes, okay, it's thick enough.
Ooh.
Feels coarse enough.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to the club, Paisan.
Then they check your chain.
Yeah. Are you going to get a chain?
I have to get a chain.
Are you going to get an Italian horn?
I don't have to get a horn, but I have to get a chain.
Just a necklace in general.
I need a necklace.
They go, I don't want you coming in here with a naked neck.
Or a pinky ring. I need a ring.
Oh, my God.
And you got to cook in like a V-neck white T-shirt.
Yeah, a wife beater.
Not a wife beater.
I'll tell you what. V-neck. Max better knock that sad shit off before Dad gets home from the Italian American Club.
No son of mine's gonna be listening to that fruit music.
You listening to that sad fruit music?
Well, it is a different place than the cigar lounge. The cigar lounge is a little more chill. They have like a movie room, a poker room, and the guys are a little more relaxed. I heard that
they also have a poke him room.
Yeah, I heard they got cameras in the toilets.
In the first floor, they have an Asian massage parlor.
No.
Yeah, down on the first floor, there's a massage parlor. Yeah. 100%. I've never been.
Sure.
I've never been.
Ting.
Lou. Oh, sorry. I've never been. I sweat nice. There you go.
That was good.
Nah, I've never gone in there and had two fingers in my butt. I've never done a table shower and... got on all fours.
Yeah, Dan, you're missing out spending all this time with Bobby. This guy lives an adventure every week. Do you know just last week in Chicago he was human trafficked?
First of all,
wait, what?
He was sexually human trafficked from he was face fucked by a Russian guy who looked Japanese.
You were here yesterday.
Oh yeah, we told you about it.
You told about it.
I heard about your little
I did not do anything
experiment.
What an experiment. I don't experiment.
You just wanted to see.
You're getting older.
Bobby, how do you know you're not gay unless you find out if you hate it?
Bobby, as you get older, tastes dull. New tastes bloom.
Yeah. You know it's very salty?
You're gay.
Cock.
Yeah. First of all, both of you, I've never done anything. And
fine.
No, it was done to you. I agree. Don't take the blame. You didn't do anything.
Yeah, no, you were a victim, Robert.
I'm not a victim, Daniel.
Bobby. It's not your fault.
Yeah. I'm not a victim.
Bobby?
But
it's not your fault.
Listen to me, Bobby.
It's not your fault.
You're about to be taken.
He's trafficked.
Yeah. Bobby, is there a big Russian man in the room? Are you wearing something sexy? You're about to be taken.
Hello.
It's so funny how close to over the show is, and I really wanted to say that we all had to start thinking of it. Me and Dan... witnessed Tiffany Haddish all weekend coming out to her theme song.
I want to hear what happened, because I'll be honest, I saw you guys having a blast.
Yeah, it's a FOMO tour.
And everybody's there. It's a FOMO tour for sure.
I'm going to feel it this weekend when Jay's on it with Lewis.
It looked a lot of fun. I was home with the family, which I love, but you guys are riding bikes.
There's me on the back.
Is that me and you on the bike?
Yeah, that's me with Big Daddy. Bert.
Is Isabella not being able to ride a bike?
Because her father didn't
teach
her.
Because I never taught her how to ride a bike.
What a sin.
Look at me go, though.
There was something to do every day, which was good and bad. Like, some days you wake up and be like, I don't want to do anything.
Now, you guys, first of all, you're on the bus, right?
Yeah, we were on the tour, but it was me, Jay, Bert, and Pete, his assistant.
So you were with Bert?
Yeah, we were on the big, bus.
That was the good bus.
It was fun as hell, dude, because we were just
The bus out. Is barely the thing. By the time you get on the bus, you bullshit for 30 minutes when it gets moving and you just don't go in your bunk.
How was the bunk?
It's great. There was only four of us, so everyone had full size.
Did you guys go on top of each other?
I went on top of Jay.
Of course you did. Yeah, because you're the top.
No.
What?
It's less dangerous if Dan collapses on me than if I collapse on him. Hey, you guys like guacamole?
Hey, I'm just saying.
I'm going pure safety here, Bobby. It was.
I've gotten in those things. I've been on the third of three straight up, like where you were up.
Yeah,
when we did the promo.
Yeah.
I was. I've been in that one before.
That's a lot. That's scary.
Legitimately been like, okay, everyone, but it's pretty weird you're putting the heaviest person like in the most can you imagine like a just two levels of crashing down,
dude. But it was a moment. There was a moment because we did Forest Hills, Queens, and then we drove to Baltimore overnight in the bus, and then woke up at the arena in Baltimore, and then just like hung out there all day and then did the show. But I woke up first, right? And Bert had to do morning radio, so him and Pete were gone, and then I woke up and went out, and they were having like a Zoom meeting, so I just had a soda and I just went and sat in the back room of the bus just like looking at my phone. And then Jay gets up, and we posted it on social media, but Jay gets up and he's like, dude, can I tell you something?
Oh yeah, this is great.
He goes,
I asked you, I go, dude, don't say it. I have to get this off my chest though.
Yeah,
I was like, I gotta tell somebody because it was so
and he
weird.
Explains to me, he goes, dude, I woke up and I went to the bathroom, the bathroom door was locked and I couldn't get it open, and I had to piss so bad that I ended up peeing in this cup and then dumping it in the sink. And he's telling me this like full on confessional.
I'm going like, dude, I feel like, should I feel bad? I know it's like a and then these things are expensive. And I go, and I took everything out of the, well, let me say, I took everything out of the sink. And I went,
tells me the whole process.
It's locked. And I'm even given the excuses already that I'm like, dude, because you know, it's that thing like when you're not sure if you can piss, somehow you can hold your piss a little bit longer while you're trying to figure out where to go. When you get up out of bed and you're like, I'm going to go piss, your mind's that like, I'm pissing.
You gotta piss.
You're on a moving bus, and it has to happen.
The door is locked for some reason from the inside.
So he tells me this, and then I have to tell him it happened to me too.
You did.
I woke up and went to piss, and the door was locked, and I had to pee so bad that I pissed into a cup, took the stuff out of the sink, dumped it in, and then
you both did it.
But and then.
We have to wait for crab feast.
So we wake up to have crab, and we're all sitting around as they unload the crabs, and Bert goes, Did you guys piss on the bus in the sink?
You guys pissed in the sink last night?
And we're like,
he asked the question. We were like,
I don't think so.
And he goes,
so.
No, we didn't. Yeah, I didn't even answer.
No, we were just like, well, he's like, because I had to. I don't know what was going on. That door was locked or whatever. And then now, Pete, of course, the one person who, the fourth person to get up, figured out it was just locked from the inside and like broke a Q-tip and just opened the door.
Popped the door open with a broken Q-tip through the thing. Now, can I do a bonfire reveal?
Yeah.
There's a good chance I was the reason that door was locked.
Oh, really?
I pissed earlier in the night in the bathroom fine, and then I went back and the door was locked, and maybe when I was fumbling around, I accidentally hit the lock.
It happens, though. I've had it in my house before.
He said that, and I was like, crazy, who had locked the door? And I was like, fuck, I did piss, and then I went back, and it was locked again.
Dan, this is the best part.
You got shit in the sink?
So here's the thing. When Dan was like, my cup is
overfold because he has too much in life.
His cup over, his Jesus cup runneth over.
Jesus loves me.
It was behind. My cup runneth like, over. He hit it behind the coffee maker, like rinsed out and everything. It's a solo cup. And then mine, I rinsed everything off, wiped things down with paper towels, stuffed the paper towels in the cup, and threw it in the garbage.
Yeah.
And then I told Dan when his was still out, I go, just throw yours in the garbage here. Then I threw a couple other things in the garbage. Then later that night, I tried eating a piece of pizza, but the Ozempic was kicking or was just gross or whatever. I just took a bite of it, and I was like, oh, I go, that's really not good at all. And then I took it, and Bert and Peter there, and I opened the trash thing, and I throw it in the trash thing again. And they're like, what are you doing? I went, throwing things in the trash. He goes, you think that's the trash? I go, is that not the trash? And he goes, it's the cooler for the drinks and stuff.
We were throwing our trash in the cooler.
Throwing piss cups in the cooler?
Yeah. Piss cups, soda, fucking pizza.
Everything, dude, just fucking throwing it right
the pizza was the worst thing. The piss cups were rinsed out. Oh, and that wasn't an issue.
It's still a piss cup.
I know. Listen, if it was my bus, I'd be upset.
Once a piss cup, always a piss cup.
Once piss touched that cup, it was a piss cup.
Oh, if it was my bus, I'd be off that tour. Like, if it was my bus and someone did it to me, I'd go, you can't just keep throwing piss stuff in the cooler. Where we're supposed to put beers.
Can you give me the pros and cons?
I mean,
Do you have to say all pros?
No, the cons were I couldn't sleep on a tour bus. I could not sleep. And then
I found a tour bus the most relaxing sleep ever because you're rocking.
I like it.
No,
the only thing that scares me is that when you think for a second, if you have to make sure your feet are the right way.
The front, you got to be facing the front.
They got to be facing the front because I jumped in one night when I first got on the bus and the guy came back and he was like, you have to switch up because if we get into an accident.
I did it one day. The very first time I was on, I laid like that, like facing on my stomach, and they were like, yo.
No, dude.
Like, got to be facing the back.
They kept hitting treads on the roads. So
and which I was makes you feel like the guy's falling asleep.
And I look way too much like Cliff Burton to not worry about that happening. where I was like, dude, don't black ice me. Don't you fucking black ice me. And then it's fucking the Dan Soder benefit. It's like, yeah. We miss him every day. But it was fucking awesome.
Yeah, that was a con for the con is like, if there's gotta be real thing, everybody on his crew
rule
is fucking great.
They rule.
So there's none of that, but like the con would be like you're sort of expected to do some things for content, which I get. I totally get.
I kept making that joke.
He pays so generously that you're like, of course I'll do it. But the second you wake up and they're like, crab feast, you're like, that wasn't what I was thinking, yeah. But all right.
I wanted to fart in my bunk and lay around and look at my phone. But
how do you argue? And then everything you do, it's like super fun that you did
it.
Exactly.
Being an influencer.
Yeah. You're a major influencer.
Major influencer. Major. And I understand that you do have to get up and you got to do stuff, man. Mm. I was at the Cure concert last night. I took some video.
Yeah.
I gave it to Christine because
you're an influencer.
We need to influence people, especially the Bonfire fans,
to not go see the Cure.
Not go see that atrocious, sad, melancholy hunk of shit.
If you're a Cure fan, you can avoid it at all. I wouldn't go.
I wouldn't either.
We are telling you right now, as a health measure, do not go see the Cure. Your son will stay home sad from school.
Yeah, them have to stay in England.
If you're, God forbid, a casual fan of The Cure, stay home.
Yeah, I wish Jay told me that when I said I'm not a fan.
I didn't know.
I said I don't want to go.
And then I was like, the Spider-Man is having me.
That's what got me. That's what got me.
Jay was doing that.
I did light up when he had the spider web on the back.
Yeah.
I did light
up. 3 hours, 45 minutes of that, though.
Oh, fuck off.
Oh, shit. We have to go so soon, but fucking bring up we didn't finish the thing about the guy shooting a shot at the OnlyFans. We didn't finish the story. I got to finish reading that.
So this is the stepson of one of the men.
Yes, the stepson, Brian Zazzes, made me think of it.
Zazzes.
Of the British billionaire.
Has been very active on social media. The story's blown up around the world. Go ahead. And the first thing was, please keep my family in your prayers. That's the right thing to say.
Sure.
Brian was back on Twitter Wednesday, first asking his followers to continue to think of his family, writing, please keep my family in your prayers. However, 30 minutes later, his attention shifted to streamer and OnlyFans model Brea. Christine, if you could bring up pictures of me, please.
Hold on,
who posted a pic of herself in a bikini with a caption, can I sit on you?
I was waiting for you to get to that.
And he wrote back, hey, yes, please. Did you see that?
Did he really?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Can I sit on you? And he goes, fucking hell, you can. I don't know. It's probably gonna take a couple days for them to pop my stepdad out of that thing like a can.
What are you looking at, Christine, to see that girl's Ozempic butt? That's does.
It's going to smell like old sardines when they open that thing.
Ozempic. Can I sit on you? Yes, please.
Yes, please is such a funny response. Yep. That's such an Austin Powers response. Yes, please.
Why? By the way, how about her saying, can I sit on you? How funny is that, that she's actually shooting her shot, sort of?
She's a pig.
And she can't be trusted. Mm. Of course, Brian's comment section started to pop off following the post. One user wrote, quote, tweeting a thirst trap while your stepdad is lost at sea is wild business. Another added, this guy loves Blink-182 and having ladies sit on his face and he's not afraid to let the world know. Oh, then he also posted, what does he wrote? It might be this. So it's a picture of this Brian Zazzes.
Also at the merch tent.
At the merch tent of Blink-182, and it says, it might be distasteful being here, but my family would want me to be at the Blink-182 show. It's my favorite band and music helps me in these difficult times.
That's so funny.
That's great.
Yeah.
I love it. I think it's fantastic.
I'll tell you what. It's balls to the wall. I know a couple days after...
Is that him?
A couple days after Kimowitz passed away, me and Christine had bought tickets a while ago to see Bryan Adams.
Yeah.
And it was just like we were sitting at home the day before it like moped completely. And it was just like we went to be like, let's go. Let's just go try to like forget for a little bit and go sit there and try to have some fun. And we went to the show and certainly didn't post post anything. We just went to the show quietly and had a good night. You know what I mean? But this guy's like, I know it seems distasteful, but my dad knows I love the Blink.
Yeah. Rock in peace. I'm having fun out here.
It was hilarious because a couple days later we went to Korn. Just like that week we happened to go to Prime. But like, I was crying at the venue.
I was crying last night at the venue too.
Yeah, I mean, they bullied you. 3:45, dude, just punishing you.
This next song is the 54th.
You calling it punishing is so funny. That they just fucking punish you. Can I sit on your face? Yes, please.
Go back to the part of the story we're at.
Oh, I thought that was the end. Sorry.
No.
It's okay, Christine.
This guy loves playing with the lady sitting on his face. Go, keep going down.
Well, calling it wild business is very funny.
As reported, Brian's the same guy who announced he was going to the concert in San Diego as rescuers scrambled to look for Harding. He posted a photo outside the concert Monday night, clearly aware it was going to come off the wrong way and defending his attendance as a way to cope. Keep going down. Is that it? Everyone handles stress differently. That's wild. So, by the way, though, it is funny because it's stepdad. How long has it been a stepdad for? Do you know what I mean?
Like, yeah, if they got married like 5 years ago, you're like, oh, fucking Lloyd? I don't know. Yeah, I don't know Lloyd,
Who's Scott? You're going to cry about Scott? I bought these tickets like a month ago.
Dude, whatever. They're back together. Tom DeLonge was never supposed to be back in the band. The aliens let him back in.
If Tom DeLonge could, anyone could find him, it was probably Tom DeLonge.
Yeah. You could get those aliens.
I respect the shit out of this kid.
And yeah, just and living
what is
his life.
Do? It's not like. He's at the
do whatever you're gonna do.
2 miles. He's 2 miles down.
Jump in her DMs is all I'm saying. Yeah. Going when she goes, can I sit on you? He can write back.
That's worse. That's worse.
No.
Quote tweet.
If
quote tweet is.
I'm saying he's doing it. He's doing
crazy.
He's doing it right in the open. Fuck it.
Nah, dude. Do you think you go
in the DMs?
Yeah, but then say I don't really care about my half bro or whatever. I think
he is saying that.
Do you think his stepmom's mom's calling him and she's going like, Brian, not right now. He goes, Mom, I want her to sit on me.
It's not my dad.
Stop.
That's the man you like.
Shut up.
I hate him.
I want him to sit on me, and I love Blink-182.
Brian Q. Zazzes.
Zazzes. Brian Cornelius Zazzes.
How about we find out he sabotaged the sub because he hates this guy?
He's like, fuck you, dude.
That'd be great.
Say hi to Rose.
It's something has done us, too. It's like he cut the brake line. Yeah. Something doesn't even make sense.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, okay. Did you look her up naked, Christine, for the love of God?
I looked up her Twitter.
Her Twitter is not
OnlyFans. I love that you could get mad at your girlfriend
fans.
For not looking up naked girls. I wish
Christine,
I could do that with Dawn.
Go to Fapello, type in Brea or Perfexia.
That's my name. God damn
Perfexia?
It.
Perfexia?
Yeah, that's my bodybuilding name.
From Canada?
Perfexia soda?
Yeah, dude. I'm sticking myself with needles, but it's pure steroids.
By the way, he is into a really batshit looking chick, dude. She's wacky looking.
He's into Blink-182, dude. It's the girl at the rock show.
That's fair enough. She looks like one of Avril Lavigne's turds. Christine, have we found her naked yet? I mean, do you want to work here?
Christine, you're doing a great job. Just settle down. That Ozempic.
Well, I guess we're going to have to let you know for the 2 seconds we come back because we have to definitely take a break.
We have to take a break.
We're hanging out with Dan Soder. DanSoder.com, RobertKellyLive.com, BigJComedy.com.
Dan Soder's going to be in Stamford, Connecticut, a New York Comedy Club in Stamford, Connecticut. It's an amazing brand new club, July 7th and the 8th, and after that he'll be in Tampa.
And
Danny Beach, Florida.
Danny Beach.
What is it? Danny Beach? What is it?
Danya.
Danya. Danya Beach. Danya. Florida, San Diego, Irvine, California. For tickets, go to DanSoder.com.
Bobby just did yes. Yes, Cuban B.
What is it?
I'm Cuban B.
I'm Cuban
yes.
B. Yes.
Cuban B.
Go to my website, RobertKellyLive.com. I got a summer tour, New Hampshire, Rutherford, New Jersey, Vegas, Rochester.
Me and Dan just New Hampshire together.
Yeah, I know you did. And it made me
we're by your tiny house.
I'm going to be by. Were you?
Yeah, we're
no, you weren't. You're in Hampton Beach.
We were riding bikes
no, we
by
weren't.
Your tiny house.
Where were you?
Gilford.
That's right where my fucking
Lake
house
Winnipesaukee.
Is.
Lake Winnipesaukee.
That's where I am.
I think we drove e-bikes by it and took pisses.
As we kissed on the e-bike.
Me and Dan totally fucked on your front porch.
It's a tiny house. I don't have a porch.
Oh, you know, whatever, that little stoop thing. So when you get out.
My three steps?
Your three steps.
Big Joe's in a fully loaded tour.
Skank store, it's fine. Skank store, going all over the place. BigJComedy.com. We'll be right back, everybody.
Back.
Or maybe we won't.
We're coming
it's
back.
The bonfire.
It's Girl at the Rock Show.
If not, we'll catch you live on Monday.
All right, Bob.
You ready? Let's do it.
We all want you to do this.
I got it. I didn't.
That's
yet.
Pressure.
Guys.
That's pressure you're putting on.
There's no pressure, guys. You know
that
why? Because everybody's looking away to make their lives better. So is Lou. Happy birthday, Lou. Maybe pre-workout before the gym or supplements to grow your hair. So why not take something that's already good? Sex and make it even better. You don't have to have a problem to take this stuff. You can just take this to make it better. Anybody can do this. All right? You want to make your partner love you even more? That's when you get the chewables from BlueChew.com. Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis.
If he doesn't move his hands, he can't do it.
But in chewable form, at a fraction of the cost.
He has to stand up and move his hands.
They also have,
or he fumbles,
Vardenafil. Okay? Yes. Mint flavored. They're the first ones to do it. Finally has a flavor, chewable, lots mint flavor, active ingredients in Levitra and Staxin. So, this is what you do. You want to stay hard and fresh?
Now.
Blue Chew is an online prescription service, so no visit to the doctor, no awkward conversations, no waiting in line, no pharmacy, and it ships right to your door in a discreet package, which I love. Sign up BlueChew.com, consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription. Right within days. So visit BlueChew.com and try it out for free when you use promo code BONFIRE at checkout. Just $5 shipping. That's BlueChew.com, promo code BONFIRE to receive your first month free. Bobby!